And let's get into Forsberg's four. And let me take a guess. It starts with Rob Williams.
It doesn't even start with Rob Williams. It ends with Rob Williams. It's all Rob Williams, because in a season of frustrations, he brings me just endless, endless joy. And last night in particular, because the box score is just a beauty. And I want to start there. The first number is 5.9%. That is what the Pacers shot when defended by Rob Williams. And as you're going to watch all these highlights, like, it's just not only the blocks, he was just scrambling over, doing everything. But 1 of 17 overall, 0 for 7 on three-pointers. Sabonis and Turner combined 1 point against Rob on 0 of 5 shooting in 8:28 of matchup time. He was spectacular.
Oh, of course you would say that Rob Williams was spectacular.
I mean, like, he was legitimately spectacular this time.
Of course he would. I will say he legitimately was spectacular. All right, what do you have coming in at number two?
All right, number two is 38.8%, and that's what opponents are shooting against Rob over the last six games. Now, let's bring up a negative. That game in Minnesota where Greg Monroe and a bunch of G Leaguers came in and dominated both the Celtics and Rob. He was challenged by Ime Udoka in the aftermath to be more disciplined. And what has Rob done but produced some of his best basketball? Opponents in that span since then, only 36 of 94 field goals made, 7 of 26 beyond the three-point arc, 38.3% overall. Like, that is such an insane number based on what Rob is doing. That's 8.9%. below their expected field goal percentage. Defensive player of the year keeps guys to like 2% below their expected. He's out there holding them 8.9% below. Amina, I know I said I wasn't going to get too gushy here, man.
I know.
This is what Rob does.
Chris Forsberg is trying to contain himself. This is him trying to contain himself right here on the set. What do you have coming into number three?
Number three, the number is 31. And what it is that's how many years it's been since the Celtics had someone who averaged over 2 blocks a game. Now, I need Rob to take this to the finish line of the season, but no one since Kevin McHale has accomplished this feat. And Rob right now, I think it's 9 straight games with 2-plus blocks. He's third in the NBA in blocks overall at 2.2 per game, behind only Miles Turner and Rudy Gobert. It's not since McHale in 90-91. And so, I mean, I don't know if it's sustainable, but he does have 31 blocks in the last 9 games.
Ooh.
And so, cock blocks everywhere.
Rob blocks everywhere. All right, last but not least, we know you're staying all Rob for this week's Forsberg's Four. What do you have for us?
So 2.7, which is Rob's foul percentage this year. Now, it goes back to what Ime said after that game against Minnesota, where he said Rob has to make sure he doesn't foul and he has to be more disciplined. Well, he's done that, because his career average is 5.1% in terms of how many possessions he would foul on. That's almost been halved this year, and it ranks in the 86th percentile among all bigs. Rob has gone to another level in every facet of his game.
My favorite thing to watch all season so far this season, I would say, is Rob being at the basket and blocking everything.
He doesn't even have to be at the basket. He could be over here. He's running over there, blocking shots over here, blocking shots.
I absolutely love it.
If I throw this paper in the air, he's going to appear out of nowhere and block it.
Appear out of nowhere and block that, too.